Hello, and welcome to Sierra Instruments' Smart Interface Program Tutorial for the QuadraTherm's latest software update, qMix. I'm Travers Newell, Associate Product Manager here at Sierra. Today, I'll be demonstrating qMix's capabilities now available for the 640i, 780i product line. With the qMix software feature, you can now compensate for gas composition changes in your application. Use qMix to create customized gases and gas mixtures and load them into your meter without ever having to send your meter back to the factory. Here's how it works. Begin by selecting qMix gas composition from the drop-down function selector on your previously installed SIP software. An activation window will appear with instructions on how to register for your free trial of qMix. Click the green button that says Register qMix Now. This will direct you to Sierra's website, where you can either register for a new account or log into an existing account. If you already have an account, fill in your email and password in the Registered Customers section. If not, fill in the New Registration section. Once registered or logged in, you'll be directed to the qMix activation page on Sierra's website. Under activation code, you will see your unique qMix activation code. You will also get an email for your records containing your activation code and confirming your registration. Next, go back to the free trial activation window and enter your unique activation code in the text field and click the Start Free Trial button in green. You will then be directed to the qMix gas composition screen, where you will see a pop-up message detailing the benefits included with your free trial. Click Continue to access qMix gas composition screen. This is the qMix gas composition screen. To the left, you will see the gas database, with over 120 gases to choose from. The middle section is called Create Gas Mix, is where your gases are added. Between these two sections are action buttons to add or remove a selected gas. To make a mixture, you must first select a gas to add from the gas database. To do this, click on the target gas and click the Add Gas button, or you can simply double click. Your target gas will appear in the Create Gas Mix section. Then enter a percentage for the target gas. For this example, I will add 20% of butane. Notice the total composition percentage now totals 20%. To edit the composition percentage of a gas, click directly on the percentage value and enter a new value. Let me demonstrate by changing butane to 25%. You will notice that the composition total at the bottom of the screen again adjusts accordingly. If you decide you want to remove a gas from the current mix, select the gas in the Create Gas Mix section and click the Remove Gas button. Similarly, if you wanted to remove all the gases from your mix at once, click the Remove All Gases button. In both cases, the composition total at the bottom of the screen will adjust accordingly. Let's go ahead and add our 25% of butane again. Then select your next target gas. I'm going to add 73% of hydrogen to the mix causing the gas composition total to equal 98%. If you have hydrocarbons in your mixture, you can utilize AGA8 equations of state in the mixture calculation, which has been determined to be more accurate for hydrocarbon mixtures. To use this feature, click the Use AGA8 button. This will cause the button to turn green. To successfully generate a gas mixture, the total percentage must equal 100%. If you try to generate the composition when the composition does not equal 100%, the process will be aborted and an alert appears. Click OK to continue. Rather than changing the target gases manually to reach 100%, you can click the Normalize Composition button. This will adjust each target gas upwards equally to make the composition total equal 100%. Once you reach 100%, a window will appear asking you to select a composition basis and enter a name for your mixture. You have two basis options to choose from, volume and mass. Both are different methods used to measure an object. Volume is how much space an object takes, and mass is the amount of matter an object contains. I'm going to choose volume as my basis and name this mixture gas mix. Next, click the Generate Gas Mix button in green. A status bar will appear showing the gas being saved to your My Gases database on your computer. Your gas mixture files are saved to the C drive under Sierra Instruments /640i/gas on your computer, along with all your other saved QTherm gases. Once finished, an alert will appear notifying you that your new gas mixture was created and can be found on the main qMix screen in the My Gases section. Click OK to continue. The My Gases section consists of three different columns. The first is the name of your mix. The second column is the type of gas mixture and will either say qMix or qTherm, depending on where it originated from. The V1 next to it is to distinguish between gas mixtures with the same name. The third column shows the composition of the mixture. This is helpful in case you forget exactly what gas and the amount are in that particular mixture. To upload a gas mixture onto your meter, first select the mixture you want to upload so that it's highlighted in blue and click the Upload Gas Mix to Meter button, which turns green when a gas mixture is selected. A window will pop up asking you to select the gas slot on your meter that you want to use to upload your gas. There are three slots to choose from on your meter. Air is in slot 1 and can't be replaced. For this example, I'm going to replace carbon dioxide in slot 2. Once you choose a slot, a window will pop up asking if you would like to save the gas being replaced to your My Gases database. If you haven't already done so, it is recommended that you save the gas so you have the option to use it again in the future. Click Yes to continue. When you click Yes, a status bar will appear showing the gas being saved to your My Gases database. Once saved, a window will pop up notifying you that your gas was successfully saved and can be found on the main qMix screen in the My Gases section. Click OK to continue. Another window will pop up asking if you are sure you want to use one of your gas upload credits to load your gas. When you register for qMix, you are initially provided with 5 gas upload credits. Each time a gas is uploaded to the meter, one of your credits is used. When you run out of credits, you will be prompted to add more credits free of charge. QTherm gases downloaded from the Sierra QTherm gas database do not require an upload credit. Click Yes to continue. A window will appear notifying you of how many credits you now have left. Click Continue to upload your gas onto your meter. You will see a status bar showing the gas being uploaded onto the meter. This may take 20 to 30 seconds. Once complete, a window will pop up notifying you that your gas was successfully loaded onto your meter. Click OK to continue. You can also upload a gas mixture onto your meter from your My Gases database. Select My Gases database from the drop-down function selector on the SIP main menu. You will see your newly created gas mixture along with any other previously saved gases. To load a gas onto your meter, first select the gas you want to add. In this example, I will select gas mix. Then select the gas slot on the meter you want to replace by clicking the flow meter gases drop-down window. For this example, I'm going to replace methane in slot 3. Then click the Upload Gas to Meter button. A pop-up message will appear asking if you would like to save the gas you are replacing to your My Gases database. If you haven't already done so, it is recommended that you save the gas so you have the option to use it again in the future. Click Yes to continue. When you click Yes, a status bar will appear showing the gas being saved to your My Gases database. Once saved, a window will pop up notifying you that your gas was successfully saved. Then click OK to continue. Another pop-up message will appear asking if you are sure you want to use one of your gas upload credits. Click Yes to continue. A window will pop up notifying you of the number of gas upload credits you now have left. Click Continue to upload your gas mixture onto the meter. A progress bar will appear showing your gas mixture being uploaded onto your meter. Once the gas is finished loading, a window pop-up message will appear notifying you that your gas mixture was successfully uploaded. Click OK and you will see your new gas mixture on your meter in the chosen slot. Sierra also has a complete online gas database for your use. To access the Sierra QTherm gas database, click the Download Gas button to view the gases available for download. These gases offer a higher accuracy, between plus or minus 0.5% to plus or minus 3.0% for the 780i and plus or minus 0.75% to plus or minus 3.0% for the 640i, instead of the standard plus or minus 3.0% of full scale you get when you create a gas mixture yourself with qMix. This is generally the result of actual gas calibrations at Sierra or updates to gas properties. The library is continually growing as new mixtures and gases are added or updated. Next, select the QTherm gas you'd like to download. You can select a gas or multiple gases from this list by holding down the Shift button. To download, click the Download Selected qTherm Gas button or simply double-click the gas you want. Once downloaded, the selected gas or gases will turn black to differentiate from the other gases still available for download and to signify that you own them. Your gas will now appear in your My Gases database. You can upload a qTherm gas by following the same instructions discussed earlier in the video, with the one exception being they do not require you to use one of your gas upload credits. This concludes the Sierra video tutorial for qMix. Thank you for watching.